Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. In today's video, we'll be diving into the world of PowerPoint and showing you how to enable developer tools. Whether you're a seasoned PowerPoint user or just getting started, the developer tools can add a whole new dimension to your presentations. So, let's get started. First things first, open PowerPoint on your computer. Make sure you're running a version that supports developer tools. PowerPoint 2010 and later versions support developer tools. Once PowerPoint is open, navigate to the ribbon at the top of the screen, look for the File tab and click on it. In the File menu, you'll see an option labeled Options. Click on Options to access PowerPoint settings. Within the PowerPoint Options window, look for the Customize Ribbon tab on the left-hand side. Click on it to reveal more options. Check the box next to Developer to enable it. This action will add the Developer tab to the ribbon in PowerPoint. After checking the Developer option, click the OK button to apply the changes and close the PowerPoint Options window. Now, look at the ribbon, and you'll see a new tab called Developer alongside the other tabs. Click on it to reveal a variety of developer tools and options. And there you have it. You've successfully enabled developer tools in PowerPoint. Before we delve into our first animation using Visual Basic for Applications, VBA, it's crucial to note that enabling developer tools in PowerPoint allows you to create and interact with custom macros, scripts, and ActiveX controls. This can be incredibly useful for automating tasks, creating interactive content, and more. If you're unfamiliar with coding for VBA, fear not, ChatGPT is here to assist us. Our task is to create an animation effect using VBA code with the help of AI. I'll provide you with a VBA code that identifies the first shape on the slide, its size and rotation, and then changes the size and rotation of all other shapes on the slide while filling each shape with a unique color. Now, let's copy the given code and return to PowerPoint. If you prefer using PowerPoint macros, you can access the PowerPoint macro feature from the View tab without enabling developer tools. However, there is a slight difference between using the macro command and the Visual Basic command from the developer tools. When you click the macros button, either from the developer or View tabs, you're presented with a window showing all the currently saved macros in the presentation. You can create, run, edit, and delete macros from this window. However, if you want to directly insert the VBA code into a new macro, you can click the Visual Basic button from the Developer tab, which will open the Microsoft Visual Basic for Applications window. Here, you need to insert a new module where you will paste the VBA code. To do this, click the Insert menu and then select Module. Paste the code given by ChatGPT, and after pasting, you can close the VBA window. The shortcut key Alt plus F11 can be used to access the VBA window again. Before running the macro, ensure you check the macro settings from the Developer tab and enable both options. Enable all macros and trust access to the VBA project object model options. Given the potential risks associated with enabling macros, exercise caution and avoid running macros from downloaded presentations. A macro-enabled presentation has a file extension of PPTM instead of PPTX. Before running our first macro, make sure to draw at least two shapes on the slides for testing purposes. To run and test a macro, press the Alt plus F8 shortcut key or click the macros from either the Developer or View tab. Select the macro from the list and click the Run button. If any errors occur in the code, feel free to ask ChatGPT about the error code and request corrections to the code accordingly. After running the macro, observe that the second rectangle shape has automatically changed its size, rotation, and now has a different fill color. Finally, we aim to replicate the same animation effect during the slideshow. For illustration, let's say that when we hover over the mouse on the first rectangle during the slideshow, all the other shapes on the slide should change their size, rotation, and fill color. To achieve this, select the first rectangle shape, go to the Insert tab, and apply an action setting. From the Mouse Over tab, choose Run Macro and then select the macro name from the list that you wish to run automatically during the slideshow when the mouse is hovered over the rectangle. Now, fill the entire slide by copying the same rectangle. This way, each copied rectangle will also have the same action settings. Run the slideshow, and when you hover your mouse over any of the rectangles, observe that the rest of the rectangles change their size, rotation, and color. Continuing to hover the mouse over the remaining shapes creates a nice animation effect. Creating, manipulating, and animating through VBA codes can open new opportunities to make animations in PowerPoint. I hope you find this tutorial